Good evening on day 26. I am just walking away from the Devil's Garden Overlook, which means I have just started walking segment 6. However, it is near the end of my day, so I have only got about a mile before I'll be setting up camp. First throw. Over the branch. Didn't get caught in anything. It's the first time this has happened on this trail. Good morning on day 27. I'm still pretty close to the beginning of segment 6 here. And I've started my descent down away from the Blue Ridge Parkway. I think I drop around 2,000 miles, 2,000 feet overall. And that'll be dropping into Stone Mountain State Park. Also, the plan for today is to walk through Stone Mountain State Park, and then this afternoon at the Stone Mountain Country Store, if all goes as planned, my dad will be meeting me with my bicycle and other cycling gear, and I'll be making the switch from foot traveler to bicycle traveler, which is something totally new for me. Obviously, I've ridden a bike, but like bike touring, it's new. So I am both excited and a little nervous about trying out this new part of the adventure. I have had a pretty intense downhill slope for the past, I don't know, mile or so. Popped off the trail for a second because I saw this massive rock, which I believe is called Wolf Rock. And yeah, it's huge and you can get a pretty good view of the surrounding area. Alright, I'm on a different big rock. And you can see over here that this is why this place is called Stone Mountain. Because of this crazy big feature over here. Another pretty cool view of a stone mountain. Looks like I'm going to be walking down below it. All right, country store. So close to get into my bicycle. Success! This is the country store, and that beautiful little adventure mobile there, I know, has brought my bicycle this far.
Well, I haven't fallen over yet. That's a good start. Okay, it has begun. I feel incredibly vulnerable.
Good morning on day 28. It is a beautiful day in downtown Elkin. I had so much happen yesterday afternoon that I didn't actually really get a chance to get anything on video, but because I'm in town, I'm gonna go start my morning with some coffee and I'll tell you all about it. All right, coffee intaken, so feeling a little more awake. Before I pedal away from Elkin today, basically yesterday, you know, afternoon, I got on my bike and I didn't do a lot of video because I'm still trying to figure out how to, like, I don't know, be safe on a bike. I don't know, still figuring it out. It's beautiful and amazing. I actually really love it. I'm just like kind of getting into my like comfortable with it zone. And because I didn't really have any idea how far I could make it, I made it pretty quickly into the town of Elkin. I didn't know that I could do that. But by dinner time, I was in Elkin, and so I was having dinner at a cafe. Elkin is a super trail friendly town, so they allow hikers, bikers, and paddlers to camp in one of their town parks, which was my plan. But as I'm having dinner, these very sweet people just kind of like pop out to the back patio where I'm sitting, and they're like, "Oh, you're on the Mountains to Sea Trail? We're trail angels. Want to come home with us?" And I was like, "That sounds amazing. Thank you so much." So I had a really lovely evening with some local trail angels. And they were great. Elkin's like, you can tell this is a very trail friendly place. It's really, really cool. And so now I've rode into town, got some coffee, and I am about to get back on the Mountains to Sea Trail. The trail, I will be more or less following the trail as I bike the Mountains to Sea Trail. I learned some things yesterday on my first afternoon on the road, and probably the most impressed upon me thing I learned is that my bike is not meant for gravel roads. Now, I knew that already. It's a hybrid bike, but it's definitely a more roadsy hybrid bike. But now I know that, like, with a lot of certainty. I do not want to take that bike on a gravel road. Because the Mountains to Sea Trail kind of does this mixture of paved roads and gravel roads and even trail, my route's going to have to be a little bit of a choose-your-own-adventure. I'm going to parallel the MST kind of as closely as I can for most of it, but I recognize that I'm kind of doing my own thing, and I'm okay with that. Like, this is just me biking my way across the middle of the state, mostly following the Mountains to Sea Trail. So, that's the plan for today. I have an idea in my head of how far I might make it, but it's such an open... There's so much I don't know. I feel like such a newbie, which is a funny feeling for me. I'm so comfortable on trail on my legs that, like, doing this, I just feel, like, excited but totally out of my element. So, anyway, I'm gonna get to it. It's actually so pretty. No, it doesn't look special, but it's beautiful. Trail is actually still marked, even though it's all pretty much on the highways here. It's the Surrey County Scenic Byway bike route. There we go. So I've stopped for lunch in the little town of Rockford. You can see behind me here, this is the Rockford General Store. Pretty much this corner is about as much as I can tell that there is of Rockford, but it's another super trail friendly place. The owner of the general store here is so sweet. I made a point to, so the trail angel I stayed with last night, they kind of know each other and work together to support MST through hikers, and so he put me in touch with him, so I made sure I stopped to say hello. And great place to stop, get some snacks, have some lunch, meet some really friendly people. This has been a great little stop along the way. I wanted to share some things that I have learned about biking in my short experience with it so far. I've had to up my sun protection game, so like sun gloves back on, you know, put this up over my face or make sure I have sunscreen for my cheeks. Also, I'm so glad that I'm doing this section on a bike, because this would be all road walking otherwise, which would be okay, but I'm really loving it on a bike. And that's the next thing. One of the things that I've learned is that it can be absolutely blissful. Today is a perfect bluebird day, and yes, the uphills are hard because it's a hilly terrain today, ups and downs. But there are these moments when I get to the top of a hill and then the world opens up in front of me. I'm like just flying down, wind in my shirt, nothing but blue sky above me, and like I said, it is blissful. I'm actually a little surprised it's taken me this long in life to learn how wonderful this is. And I know part of it is the novelty of, you know, just something new, and maybe that will wear off. Maybe in a few days I'll kind of be over cycling, but I don't think so. It is so just awesome. And you're getting this amazing exercise. Like, I'm getting my heart rate up going up some of these hills. So Yeah, it's been a super pleasant day so far. Last thing I was going to say is just that today, because I'm kind of learning how far I can make it on a bike, I think I will definitely make it to Pilot Mountain State Park, which is the end of segment 6, which means that I will be able to meet another family member. My mom is going to meet me there if all goes as planned. Also, I mentioned yesterday that my dad was the person who, you know, brought me my bike and helped me make that gear switch. So just huge shout out and thank you to my dad for being willing to be like sort of the gear point person to help make this like slightly more complicated trail biking kayaking thing just go so much more smoothly. So super grateful. Thanks, Dad.
So if you look out this way, you can see Pilot Mountain, which is the knob right back there. Oh, sorry, that's just a shot on my finger. Anyway, you can see the knob, Pilot Mountain, back there, which amazingly I will be at either later today or certainly by tomorrow. I am completely amazed that, I don't know, within an hour or so, I've traveled from this being a sight in the distance to one that feels like it's right in front of me. Biking is fast.
All right, so I have just arrived at the parking lot at the northern end of the corridor trail, and that is kind of right at the southern end of the main part of Pilot Mountain State Park. I am just hanging out here waiting to see everything, got everything just laid to rest for the moment. I am just hanging out here waiting for my mom, who has kindly agreed to meet me. And this actually brings this is the end of segment 6. Pilot Mountain State Park is kind of the start of segment 7. So yeah, it's been a great first day on the bike. I'm actually going to get in a few more miles tonight walking through Pilot Mountain State Park. So we can look forward to that for the beginning of segment 7. Hello, family. All right, here we go. Starting segment 7 with a little bit of walking to finish a day of riding. Headed into Pilot Mountain State Park. Gonna go up somewhere close to that knob. I don't know when this fire burnt through here, but you can clearly tell this is a burn area. So my plan for segment 7, and really all of the sections in the Piedmont, is to primarily cycle, because there's a lot of the trail that is on roads. There are, however, some completed sections of trail, and when possible, and it will not always be possible, but when I am fortunate enough to have, you know, family, someone that can help me shuttle my bike around some of those trail portions, I'll hop off the bike and walk a bit. And that's the situation tonight. Sorry, I'm walking up. If you can't tell. So I am gonna do kind of a quick, about 4 miles through Pilot Mountain State Park. And then my mom's gonna meet me on the other side. With my bike and everything, but from that point, I think she's probably just gonna take me home with her, so thanks, Mom. So when I looked at the map, I initially thought that this portion of the mountains to sea trail would connect with the trail that goes around the knob at the top of Pilot Mountain. But I was wrong. It does go around the mountain, but it goes around lower. So not gonna get a view from the top tonight. I've actually seen it many times. I just, you know, thought it would be cool, but maybe tomorrow. We'll see. Well, I finished my little 4 mile jaunt through the state park. Feels good to not have a pack, a bike, anything. Just feel like you can run. So since I made it a little ahead of schedule, I'm just waiting on my mom to meet me on the other side, hanging out at the visitor center here. Pilot Mountain has a pretty cool, like, new visitor center you can check out if you want to learn a little bit about the area. Good afternoon on day 29. I am back at the visitor center here in Pilot Mountain State Park. I just said goodbye to my mom and her husband Michael, so big thank you to them for meeting me yesterday, helping me get my bike shuttled around this part of the park, and then of course taking me home and feeding me and all that good stuff. So yeah, gonna get back on the road here shortly and ride my way to the next state park, which will be Hanging Rock State Park. Just looks like spilt paint, but those are, I believe that's actually a trail blaze right there. That's Hanging Rock State Park coming into view right ahead of me there, so I am definitely making progress. Almost there. Ooh, that was a big hill. Whew. So I've only got about a mile left to where I'm supposed to meet my my dad's gonna meet me today at Hanging Rock State Park. And it is all uphill. Well, it's a killer last mile, but if I look back behind me, it's really pretty. And then, of course, Hanging Rock right there ahead. Made it. Tori's Den. Hee. And there's my lovely car. Okie dokie, so the plan for this afternoon is to be back on foot for a little while I walk through some of Hanging Rock State Park. Pretty similar to the little jog my mom helped me with yesterday where, you know, I just met my dad and gave him my bike and things, and then I'm going to walk for a bit, and then he's going to meet me at the visitor center on the other side of the park. So, yeah, that parking lot where I met him, the Tori's Den Trailhead, I believe the MST cross is just down the road from there. At least that's what it looks like. So I'm on my way to go find my trail and start hiking. And I have to say, I was pretty tired after that mile of uphill biking to get to that parking lot. So if I have any more climbing to do today, I will be happy to do it on foot. All right, here we go. Well, I've been climbing most of my way through my walk of a Hanging Rock State Park, and the trees are what they are, but you can see that I've definitely gained some elevation from down below there where I was when I was on my bicycle not too long ago. Well, this is pretty cool. I am at the top of a Moor Knob, or Moore's Knob, one of those two, and looking west here, you can see everywhere I've come from. So Pilot Mountain you'll definitely be able to see, and then I don't know if we can really see it today, but
Mount Mitchell is back that way, just tucked behind Pilot Mountain, 120 miles away, which is pretty neat. And I've come through a lot of these places. I was right underneath Grandfather Mountain when I was close to Linville. Walked by Doughton Park a few days ago. I think it was a few days ago. Some time ago. Yeah, so looking west, you can get kind of an idea of everywhere that I've come from, which is pretty neat. And then, of course, this is off to the north. And then also exciting for me is looking out east, the way that I'm headed. That's Hanging Rock right in front of us there. And you can actually see the visitor center, which I'll be headed to too. Sorry, the bugs are terrible right here. I don't know why, what it is about this spot, but they're really digging it. Anyway, yeah, and then, you know, if you use your imagination, way out there somewhere is the Outer Banks. But you can certainly see the landscape get drastically flatter, which I'm kind of excited about. So segment 7 is a pretty short segment compared with the other segments. It's only about 35 miles long and basically runs from Pilot Mountain State Park to the Visitor Center in Hanging Rock State Park, which I will be at pretty shortly. Be meeting my dad there, I think, within the next mile or so. So yeah, it's been a short and sweet little segment. But I have definitely enjoyed getting to see some, like, somewhat familiar stomping grounds in a totally new way. Cool. And success! This is the parking lot for the visitor center, which is just over there on the left. You can see my dad, so yeah, this will wrap up segment 7.